slow. Ah, what a way to segue into the beginning of a show. Here we are. That's really, I was just outside. I had to deliver an artist out to the Cokes Island Festival. It was just a little, one of those September evenings, you know, where I had to put on my Mr. Rogers sweater. And you know, because that movie's coming out, no one can wear a cardigan again without being saying, oh, you've coffee and doctor, you're coffee and Mr. Rogers. But I used to have a whole bunch of cardigans. I did. They were cool. I had a terrible episode one time, though. I found a couple of cardigans. When you find clothes that fit, it's really nice to have that happen. And if they're used, that's even better. But when you happen to be at a garage sale, and it was one of those ones where it was an early Saturday morning. I didn't plan on going, but I got there. And at that time, I was wearing a plate, so one of my teeth was out. I had a bit of a growth of a, you know, I hadn't shaved that day. And I was looking a little scruffy, but I went to this wonderful garage sale down on in a little secluded area off Lake Cowichan Road. Beautiful setting with a little creek going through. And lots of things for sale. But I went up onto this up by the front window, the picture window, and I noticed there was a bunch of clothes there. And as I started trying them on, I realized they all fit. And if I looked, and the reason I knew that is because I could look in the front window and it became a mirror because of where the sun was, right? So I was checking them all out and it was real good. Because for a tall guy, it's really hard to find something that fits. And unfortunately, when I moved over to a little bit to the side, I realized the person who owned the clothes was lying on the couch dying. And this was the garage sale they were doing. And I was hoping that we had this tall person connection, right? That he enjoyed the fact that another tall person was coming wearing his clothes and not just some slovenly looking hippie. But as it worked out, I went back to actually thank him about a week later and found out that he had passed away. So, you know, that's just the way life goes. But that's a journey, right? And tonight we're going on a journey. We're going on a crystal journey. And this is wonderful that Mr. Hickey, Bill Hickey's brought this whole... I've never seen the showroom look like this. This is wonderful. Can you stay? You have as many clips as I do for hanging cloth. You have a penchant for making a place change, right? And that's what we're going through tonight, is a change. Sound is a wonderful thing. And it moves us, and we're all affected by change and by that tones and everything else that goes on. As in our names, you know. My grandfather could call me Johnny. I would respond differently to him than I would if I was just John. So all the tones and all the things in life do affect you, how you go about your life. So tonight the journey is about all the sounds that are available to us that will help change and sometimes challenge us as to our belief system, as to what sound is and what things are, and make you think a lot about what life's all about. It's going to be a fun, wonderful journey. Thanks, sir, for bringing this to us once again. Hey, it's a treat. It's a nice treat. Let's get the show on the road, please.
I love storytellers. I'm a storyteller, which is why my wife's in the van. Have lots, but tonight we'll start off with the music. Thanks, Johnny. What a place.
Beautiful.
This is awesome. I got my daughter in here, she's 5, and she wanted to listen to Christmas music on the drive here this morning. So we gotta do what she says. So we put on the Rat Pack Christmas, it's our favorite. So, you know, we're a few months away from Christmas, but you know, you can never not love Christmas music. So that's what we were listening to, and the first thing I see when I come in here is Santa Claus over there. So I told her, I said, you know, Santa's in there, because she didn't want to come in. She was just like, I'm busy in the van. And I said, Santa's in there. I talked to him. He said he wants to see you. He said, I heard you were listening to Christmas music today. I just want to say thanks. So she's like, really? And I said, yeah. And she comes in, and there's Santa there. And what a trip. This Santa's here tonight, so... What a great space, all this memorabilia. I've been actually on a real journey of being nostalgic on this tour. So coming in here has just been, wow, I love it. All the records and the old Rolling Stone magazines, and John's got all the ducks up there. He says, I got all my ducks in a row, you know, we're in for a good night. So thanks for being here, and we're going to have a wonderful trip. We've got these beautiful crystals here, getting charged up. We've got the water here. You guys are going to take that back to where you're doing your work, and I appreciate the, you know, the trust to do that. And so we're going to do two sets tonight. We'll take a very short break. Got some CDs. I think some popcorn's been made, or it's going to be made. And then we'll come back with the second set. We'll start off on the Persian Santur. We'll move into the gongs. Tonight we have Mercury, the Moon, Venus, Mars, the Symphonic Gong, Earth, Neptune, and Saturn tonight. And then we'll work our way over to this side and end on this Santur for the second set. So thanks for being here. take a short break. We'll come back with the second set.
So I'm not sure if this is the journey that has taken you someplace and now we're on our return way back, or whether or not it's just we're on to go. I would rather believe that this is just a short stop onto the final destination where the evening will have ended up taking us to. Because the different comments from people is, yes, there's an amazing thing that does take place when you are part. And specifically for this room, because this room is designed for that, with all the seats facing the front. It's always been my dream. Having worked with a gentleman by the name of Willie P. Bennett, a great Canadian singer-songwriter, having been in many places where I knew he could take us on a wonderful emotional journey with his music, but there was never an ability to do that because there would always be conversations going on and things like that. So henceforth came this whole venue, was to make sure that we could go on those journeys. And those that are here tonight, you understand, like there's a transition that happens, that the outside is just not there anymore. Like what is it? What were you doing earlier today? Does it really matter? It doesn't, because we're in the middle of a journey right now. We stopped off, maybe Calgary or Regina on a cross-country tour, I would say, if I was thinking of a journey.
How about Venus or Mars?
Yeah. Okay. But nonetheless, yeah, we pick the country of your choice or wherever the journey is, but do enjoy this musical extravaganza. And thank you very much, sir, for doing this. The second part of the show.
lost another 2 pounds. I'm going to be nothing by the time we get back to Ontario. Wow.
Fabulous.
Thank you.
Yeah, fabulous.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, women, in the car.
I hope you like your knees, David.
What's that?
I hope you like your knees.
My knees?
Well, that's what's in the photos. Mostly the knees.
Oh, seriously? That's all right.
Shaking up the place. Did he call you up late at night? Did he say I love you, babe? Gonna treat you right.